Your Excellency Enrique Peña Nieto and your beautiful daughter, Paulina, distinguished members of the Mexican delegation, Senate President Franklin Drilon, and members of the Senate present, Speaker Feliciano Belmonte Jr., members of the House of Representatives present, Secretary Albert De Rosario, members of the Cabinet, Excellency Giuseppe Pinto, Dean of the Diplomatic Corps, Excellencies of the Diplomatic Corps, Ambassador Julio Camarena Villaseñor, Ambassador Catalino Direm, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Your Excellency, as I mentioned to the press today, for nearly half a millennium, the history and the culture of Mexico and the Philippines have been deeply intertwined. Both our countries have fought for our freedom and have thus truly learned to value and protect it over the years. The Philippines had our centuries-long colonial period, as well as the martial law era, while Mexico had the period of Maximilian and Carlota, as well as your long revolution that laid the foundations of your democracy. Our shared struggle, however, also had the result of connecting our nations. Beginning in the 16th century, the generations that preceded us witnessed the galleons sailing back and forth between Manila and Acapulco. And to this day, the effects of our historic exchange are undeniable. In fact, in the region of my forefathers alone, there is already strong evidence of our connection. In Pampanga, which is a province north of Manila, there is actually a municipality named Mexico, famous for its churches built during the Spanish colonization. There is also a town called Macabebe in the same province, whose inhabitants trace their ancestry, allegedly, to Mexican Indians. You can also look at our language. It is unsurprising that many of the words we have come to adopt from Nahuatl are somewhat related to trade. We have not one but two words for market that have Nahuatl roots. Changue, derived from changi, palenque, derived from palenque also. There are also words for plants and vegetables. I'm told sayote from chayote, camote for camotli, sili from chili, sincamas from sicamat, among many, many others. I also remember that back when I was in university, which was a time when we were all required to take Spanish classes, we had to practice dialogues in Spanish. And for the most part, they were always in a Mexican setting. So to this day, I remember one particular dialogue which had me saying, vamos a Chapultepec en autobús para comer comida china. I don't know why the Filipino had to go to Mexico riding an autobus to eat Chinese food. At the same time, I'm told that Filipinos have had their own major contributions to Mexican life. And this is the Filipino version of the story. Apparently, the process of distilling agave came from partly from the adaptation of Philippine techniques in distilling coconut or spirits derived from coconuts. It was also the Philippines that introduced, allegedly, mangoes to Mexico, and perhaps proof of this is how we can still find Mexican mangoes labeled Manila mangoes. The extent of what binds us may well be immeasurable, and we are pleased to welcome you here to the Philippines. After all, the last state visit by a Mexican head of state was 37 years ago. And I believe we can both agree that given our shared past, our cultural affinity, and our shared commitment to growth that can be felt by all, our partnership can help pave the way for greater prosperity for our nations and our peoples. Indeed, it is high time for us to expand our ties further beyond the realm of history and give rise to an even broader partnership between our nations, one that can truly honor the Manila-Acapulco galleon trade. I assure you, we Filipinos are eager to work with you and write the next chapters of the history that we share. At this point, may I propose a toast to the success and health of His Excellency Enrique Peña Nieto, to a deeper and more meaningful partnership between our nations, and to the enduring friendship between the Mexican people and the Filipino people. Salud.
Señoras y señores, muy buenas noches a todas y a todos ustedes. Excelentísimo señor Benigno Aquino III, presidente de la República de Filipinas, muy distinguidos integrantes del gabinete de su gobierno, muy distinguidas personalidades que hoy aquí nos acompañan, del ámbito empresarial, del ámbito académico, del ámbito social, distinguidos integrantes de la Delegación de Empresarios de México, que está presente hoy aquí en Filipinas, muy distinguidas señoras y señores. Quiero agradecer la cálida bienvenida que el pueblo y el gobierno de Filipinas nos han brindado en esta memorable visita de Estado. Particularmente quiero agradecer la generosa distinción que me ha conferido al imponerme la condecoración de la Orden Sikatuna. Hace 450 años zarpó de tierras filipinas, como él lo ha referido el señor presidente, el galeón de Manila rumbo al puerto de Acapulco, llevando mercancías desde Asia hacia América. Esta histórica ruta comercial unió a nuestras naciones y hermanó a nuestros pueblos. A más de 4 siglos de distancia, sigue siendo un símbolo de nuestra identidad compartida. En el siglo XX, la entrañable relación de amistad entre ambas naciones nuevamente quedó manifiesta cuando, en el marco de la Segunda Guerra Mundial, México apoyó la defensa de Filipinas con el envío de la Fuerza Aérea Expedicionaria Mexicana, el reconocido Escuadrón 201. A más de 7 décadas de ese conflicto bélico, hoy a Filipinas y a México los une el compromiso de transformarse positivamente para elevar la calidad de vida de sus sociedades. En este encuentro entre dos naciones hermanas, señor presidente, quiero reconocer la gran aportación que la familia Aquino ha hecho a la democracia de su país. La lucha de sus padres y de usted mismo en defensa de las libertades y los derechos de los filipinos no ha sido nada fácil, pero ha dado grandes frutos. Presidente Aquino, usted encabeza un gobierno que proyecta al mundo un compromiso irrevocable con la modernización de Filipinas y el bienestar de su gente. Excelentísimo señor presidente, México reconoce a Asia-Pacífico como una región esencial en este siglo XXI y a Filipinas como un gran aliado de nuestro país. Con esta visita de Estado, honramos nuestro pasado, celebramos nuestras coincidencias actuales y nos comprometemos con un mejor futuro para filipinos y mexicanos. Con este ánimo fraterno, quiero pedirles el que me acompañen en un brindis. Quiero hacer este brindis, en primer lugar, por el pueblo de Filipinas. Quiero brindar por el bienestar de su excelencia, el señor presidente Aquino de la República de Filipinas. Y quiero brindar porque los acuerdos que hemos concretado el día de hoy permitan realmente impulsar la prosperidad de nuestras sociedades. Salud. Salud. Mabuhay. Mabuhay.